V'chartanu mikol ha'amim, mikol ha'amim, v'hartoi sanu v'rasi sabanu, v'hartoi sanu v'rasi sabanu.
We will begin on the line that begins with one halasogas. This is eight lines from the beginning, seven lines from the beginning of that second, of that section that begins on that page of Tess. Halasogas Hillel. We already went through this. We're going in because we want to make certain emphasis. At the end of that line, we pointed out just prior to this line that when the oiris of the Sechel, of the Svara, find the Keli, whether it's a keli of Shammai or Hillel, Kriya Gvura, Kriya Chesed, and then the oiris are compelling, are illuminating the principles of Chesed or Gvura, depending on the keli. That phenomenon that the oiris at that point begin to compel in one direction or another is not exclusively due to the keli. Rather, it is an inherent element within the oil itself. The oil itself begins to compel the union of chesed and gvura. Although, in its origin, by the Rav, there is no such direction in the oil. It is oil aposhut, oil habsechel aposhut. Nonetheless, when it comes into the keli and it then reveals the element of chesed or gvura, that it reveals it on an essential level, that the oil itself is directing you towards chesed or gvura. And now it explains why is this behind, and that is lefi shesibas bechinas chesed or gvura shebeiris. Because the sibo means the cause of the aspect of chesed and gvura in the yoyres, ein rak mitzad hakelim abad, is not, it's only due to the effect of the keli, like in the case of the water being colored by the glass, where the water has no inherent natural colors at all. But the oyer, this is not the effect of the keli only, that it has the tendency towards chesed and gvura. It's not only due to the keli, ki yim mitzad shoresh u'mokor ha'oir. But in fact, it is due to the very root of the oir itself. This is a very broad space statement. The fact that the water can be represented in one color or another is due to the fact that the water is representing, so to speak, the neutral color.
The neutral?
Neutral color.
Kind of.
The water represents the color that it takes from its source, which is totally neutral. And then, as it materializes in a cup, it remains neutral, although it acquires the color of the cup. Here we're saying that the oil of the Svara Sichlis, and as we taught many times lately, oil means that which is emanates from a source, from an etzem. That's what oil is. I don't know if I need to repeat this, and I'm repeating it every time that I mention it. You should understand that oil is not an external manufacturer. Oil does not become oil when it hits an object, like it is interpreted.
It's not like a candle. Oil from a candle.
I'll attend to that question in a candle. First we have to, because once we start into this, we may misunderstand. When the oil hits an object, then the object becomes visible. This principle, that the oil makes the object visible, physically, it occurs at the time when the oil hits the object. But in reality, there's an element in the oil from its source perspective that it has the quality that it reveals everything that there is to be revealed. And it's not due to the fact that it hits an object, but due to the presence of oil itself. I'll come back to the candle, you see. That would be a little too involved to bring the same meaning out of the candle. But oil means that there is a presence of the source for the oil.
And that's what we just mentioned, revelation. Not by means of hitting an object, but rather it just shows what's there.
Right. This is the meaning of oil. Like we say, from the perspective of the sun, darkness does not exist. Not that the sun can count in darkness, but darkness simply doesn't exist. To the sun, light is of the same fundamental reality present as darkness to us. So this inyan, that the chesed and gevurah emanates from the oir, he says, mitzatzereshu mokor oir, means that actually in the very root of the oir there is this inyan of chesed and gevurah. What is the root of the oil? Like we said, the shemesh is etzem behiri, and therefore the oil that comes from the shemesh is rooted in the fact that etzem behiri is, in an absolute element of behiri. What is the root of the oil? Hasechel. The oil has seichel that comes from the lab. And I want to again take this into some kind of a concrete moment. We distinguished many times between the statement one and one is two ones, or one one and one is two. I hope that this reverberates with most of us. Two ones is not seichel. It's not oira seichel. On the contrary, it simply is subserving itself to the physical phenomenon. There are two ones. Seichel brings a new perspective onto the physical environment. It says one and one is two. The two is a psychological concept, not a physical presence. This Inyan, that Sechel, has this kind of illumination, this kind of concept of two, is rooted in a high reality. This reality is that two tells you about the truth of existence more than one.
More than two ones.
So therefore, the Chesed Gevurah Sheboeiris is mitzad Sheiros Shumoker Ho'er, because the Oir represents its own source. Why is there Oir? Because there is a truth that emanates the Oir. In simple terms, what motivates someone to know one and one is two ones, and what motivates someone to know one and one is two? In other words, what's the compelling element behind it? When you speak, for example, about money, $2 does not become a new spirit. It's two at once. A dollar is a dollar. And if it joins with another dollar, it doesn't become any more significant than when it is alone. They will understand the statement from seeing the other people. Just want to conclude it. The second dollar does not base itself on the first dollar. It comes independently completely. When two people join together, one is encouraging the other. The second one is definitely encouraged and inspired by the fact that there's another one there. And retroactively, the first one is inspired by the second one. This is two. And the reason there is that too is because in the Sechel, the reason that the first one says such and such is not simply because it's advantageous, because it's like $1, but he has a spiritual, he has a sense of its value, of its truth. And then if he can imbue that truth into someone else, that's enhanced by it. This is the pshat seichel oyer. This, the examples for this are rampant, we already discussed it many, many times. Just wanted to explain the words Shoyrushu Mokoy Hoyer. Like we said, I hope you don't lose it. A table fixed in the dining room, not because there's room for the table, but because there is the concept of a dining room that gives inspiration to the table.
Wait, this last point is like lifting the physical out of one to one. It's like giving it an almost human spirit of
it is.
Union.
Okay. Yes. Okay. Yeah, the idea is that, yes, that there is a, this is what oil is. Oil emanates from a shoyrish or mokir. Why is there a dining room? Because there's a human being. Not because there's space. Why is there $2? Because there's $2. There's no human inspiration for that. As a matter of fact, these days, nobody sees dollars. You see only numbers. On the computer, who doesn't know at all the different significance of these numbers. Human beings cannot be substituted by these kind of methods.
Who's there, Rabbi? I didn't hear you.
They have to be real human beings. What?
What was that? What was that last statement, Rabbi? I didn't hear you.
I said that. When you talk about dollars are being calculated these days on the computer by numbers.
Right.
Human beings cannot be counted by numbers. Human beings have to be present themselves. This is the chat. Shereshum Moker Hoyer. The reason there is oil is because there is a reality behind it. And this is what gives the oil its particular quality. Chesed or gevurah. Yes.
Remember we explained a makor is not a reservoir for whatever it represents. Rather, it takes the inherency of this opinion and brings it about. A shedesh, what we learned previously, is like an expression of this in a higher level, or it's like a tree root is like a tree but under the ground. So how can something operate as both these two if they don't seem like they seem like two different to us entirely? So how can it be both these inyanim in one thing?
Okay, a good question, a valid question, but it's not for us right now. It's not for you for now right now either.
Okay.
Some other time. Okmoy hachesed gevurah shebehasvara gabi shama vehile. As in the case of chesed gevurah, drawn from the very svara, gabi shama vehile, that surfaces by shama and hile. Harei. Okay, this is very important. Harei, so there, hasi bahu, the cause for the chesed gevurah within the svara, as it is recognized by Shammai and Hillel, the cause for this is mipnei, it is due to the fact shagam bisvaras horav, that also even in the svara, in the pure sechel of the rav, yesh bo chesed gevurah. There is the Yifal Chasin Gura Behalem in a camouflage and a subtle manner. But this says, and we discuss it many times, Hilel and Shabbai are learning from Shmai Vavtali. And Shmai Vavtali are giving them as far as Sichlis. When Hilel and Shabbai are learning this water from Shmai Vavtali, what is their intent? What are they focused on? To see their inclination within this water that Shmai Vavtali is giving them? Or to see what Shmai Vavtali is giving them? Pure and simple. They're dedicated totally to understand what Shmai Vavtali is saying. If then, as a result of learning purely what Shmai Vavtali is teaching them, they come up with the result of Chesed and Gevurah, it is only due to the fact that this word of Shmai Vavtali incorporates and allows for Chesed and Gevurah to emanate from it. It is not that they're learning it with a prejudice. Let me go and learn Shmai Vavtali and I'm going to justify my view. That is not learning. This is not how you Shama learned. So if Hillel was able to find in Svara of Shmai Vavtali, Yifu Chesed is due to the fact that in that Svara there is that in you. Except Hillel, because of his particular quality by inclination, he detects that Inyan in that Svara. Shama detects a different Inyan in that Svara. So the Rav, the Chesed and Gevurah is Behelem. The principle of Behelem, again, we have dealt with this concept, this whole, for quite some time. In principle, this is nothing new, be aware, but I just want to bring it back again now. In principle, the union that there is Chesed and Gevurah in Behelem, in this world of Shmai Vavtali, is rooted in the fact that Shmai Vavtali would not create a Svara in a vacuum. The Svara that Shmai Vavtali was explaining had significance in the world. The reason that they were attending to the world, because the world, this is their place, this is the place I was assigned to them to deal with. This is what the Rebbe said is revealing himself to the world. This was not an obscure, some kind of abstract concept. None of the Chachamim dealt with abstract concept. The Araya, the most clear statement, he says, what are you supposed to when you learn? Asuki shmaitze aliba di hilchese. Which means, you learn something, you have to draw the learning all the way to the point where you come to a halacha. If it's an abstract concept, what is that halo with Allah? Sechel, by definition, deals with reality. There is no value to Sechel for its own, just because this is an abstract concept.
Okay.
There's more to speak about, but I think that's enough. So therefore, in this world of Shmai Baftalian, there was the harem. Didn't you have a chassidim for? Why is it behelem, not begil, not bimtzis? Because they saw this inyan at a higher level, where the mitzvahs is unnecessary to be identified. It doesn't exist by definition. It exists mitzad the hell, like we have gave our moshul. We gave our moshul of someone standing on a high place, looking down, and he sees two points on a long, on a huge stretch of land. Two points. These two points by him exist at the same time. It isn't like you have to go from point one to point B. There's no distance between them. So he sees these two points, what's called bipshitus, by virtue of the fact that they both occupy, they're both present in the same area. Not because you can get from one to the other. When you go down to the labyrinth of streets, then these two points are related only because you can get from there, from one to the other.
So on the one hand, from above is like no metzius. On the other hand, it's not abstract. It's not. It is.
It's not abstract. That's right. It's not abstract. It's not just conceptually. Yes, it is there. But it is there not by virtue of some kind of a functional connection. Put it this way. This one exists here. This one exists here. That's a pure truth. This exists by itself. It has nothing to do with anything else. This exists by itself. That both exist is also a pure truth. And that both exist in proximity to one another is also a pure truth. Not due to the fact that you can make a connection between them. You can go from one to the other. In Sechel, you have to justify. How are you going to get from one to the other?
Yeah. I guess I'm trying to understand the previous point made that by Sechel, Torah Sechel, it's not abstract. On the other hand, it is completely mufshat or superior to.
No. It's not mufshat. It's poshut, not mufshat. It has a significance. It has a statement, but the statement is made by pshitus.
Here, having a statement means it has practical relevance.
That's right.
And then the second piece of that is that it's made from...
Mipshitus. It doesn't need to be justified and explained. Why do you have a table in the middle of a dining room? There is no why. It belongs there.
So, So on the one hand, it's not certainly not circumstantial, not governed by what occurs on the practical level, yet it's relevant at the outset to
practical, to reality.
To reality, to a practical situation.
This is said that there is chesed and gevurah behelem. What's the difference in helem and gilus? Very briefly, like we said, two points looked at from above, you don't have to make a connection between them. They're in the same area, but there's a distance between them that doesn't have any significance. When you go down, and then you find what is the way that he can walk from one to the other, that reveals their relationship.
You go down, that reveals the relationship. But what is the first part?
That their relationship is not. It's not. There's no statement made about it. They're both in the same place. Say, oh, there are two places. There are two places. That's. There is no statement. No significance to this point. Statement said that there are two points there. That you can walk from one to the other. No significance.
That's
Behelem? Huh?
That's
Behelem? That's sometimes the inner is Behelem. Alright, let's go daven. I'm sorry, I have to interrupt. Today we have to daven on time. Alright, whatever we accomplish, we'll continue next year. Have a great day.
Ya 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 ya